When you write a note, what hand do you use? How about when you catch a ball or open a jar? Pretty much everyone knows what it means to be right or left-handed. But why are so few people left-handed? And what's going on in the brain? Hey there, I'm Alie Astrocyte. Let's talk about the neuroscience of handedness. Like around 90% of the world's population, I'm right-handed. But if you are left-handed, you're not alone. About 10% of the population, or around 700 million people, are just like you. And a very small number of people are somewhere in between. Either cross-handed, where their dominant hand varies based on the task, or truly ambidextrous, where they can use either hand equally well for pretty much anything. It's pretty unclear how different people end up with different dominant hands, but there does seem to be some sort of genetic component. Left-handedness is more common in males, and if both of your parents are left-handed, there's about a 26% chance that you'll be left-handed too. And scientists have found connections between being left-handed and differences in genes having to do with left-right asymmetry. What the heck is that? Well, in general, we're pretty symmetrical creatures, but there are a few things that have to be asymmetric, like our hearts and our guts. So left-handedness could be a product of tiny changes in a bunch of these genes, but we're still not exactly sure what makes a person left-handed. There's also some evidence that handedness could be influenced by exposure to different hormone levels in the womb, like androgen hormones, which may be why women who are left-handed have a higher risk for breast cancer. What does this have to do with the brain? Like our hearts and our guts, our brain is somewhat asymmetrical. That means that there are some things that are only on one side or the other. Scientists know that there seems to be a connection between your handedness and lateralization. That is, which side of your brain processes different tasks. Now, I'm not talking about things like being left-brained or right-brained. It's a myth that being creative or analytical are connected to a dominant brain hemisphere. But there are a few things that one side of your brain tends to control more than the other, like language. So since I'm right-handed, it's really likely that the left side of my brain takes care of the majority of my language processing. This is true for about 96% of people who are right-handed. But on the flip side, someone who's left-handed has a nearly 30% chance of having language controlled mostly by the right hemisphere. As I mentioned in our language video, for most people, the left hemisphere handles most of the language tasks. But people who are left-handed are more likely to have a more mixed-up arrangement, with both sides of the brain becoming active during language processes. A very small fMRI study looking at brain activation during a memory task found some differences related to handedness too. In a task where people had to remember and recall paired sets of words, participants who were left-handed had more activation in their left hippocampus and amygdala than those who were right-handed. It needs more work, but this is some of the first evidence that memory might also be lateralized in the brain. You may have heard that being left-handed means you're more likely to be a genius. After all, lots of brilliant people are left-handed, like Michelangelo, Helen Keller, Bob Dylan, and Barack Obama. There are even websites that claim that 20% of Mensa's members are left-handed. But sorry, lefties, that's a myth. Research hasn't found any significant difference in intelligence between people who are left or right-handed. If anything, there's a slight benefit to being right-handed. But it's really hard to even say much about the pros or cons of being left-handed because it's so understudied. Unfortunately, people who are left-handed are often excluded from scientific studies because handedness might add a confound to the research. That is, an unknown effect of being left-handed could influence the outcome of the study. So there are a lot of unanswered questions when it comes to handedness and the brain. But it's still a curious thing, and there are researchers out there who are trying to figure it out. It's especially interesting because we don't understand the role of lateralization in general. Why are our brains asymmetrical? And how does that influence our behavior and personalities? Eventually, we might be able to figure it out and find out what other interesting traits are tied to handedness. Thanks for watching this episode of Neurotransmissions. Until next time, I'm Alie Astrocyte. Over and out.